Hi, Larry.
I'm just coming off of the intro music, kind of chill right now.
Yeah.
I was experimenting with a new intro there. That was one we used at PAX.
Oh, so can you dance to it?
You can. I wouldn't. Laura can. I can't.
Larry wouldn't. As we've already discussed.
Yes. Yeah, so this is
waltzes sort of... only for this gentleman.
Welcome.
We're in a suit.
No, not at all. It's just
waltzes are the best. Don't diss waltzes.
I'm not dissing waltzes. I'm just saying dancing is not as has been proven on a public stage. That is not my thing. I'm not best at it.
You know, I would say dancing by yourself, super difficult. But partner dancing is actually really fun.
It is
not
fun.
Nearly as intimidating.
Show number 608 here talking about dancing. It's the dancing edition, the dancing with no stars edition.
Finally, a dancing podcast. I found my calling.
Just dance.
You know,
2018. I'm sure it's awesome.
It's interesting because have you ever gone square dancing?
Maybe.
Is this the spin your partner round and round? Is that really a thing, by the way, or is that
well,
just...
all I know is I remember when I was in Connecticut, I was this person that I was dating. Her dad was a big-time caller.
That's right.
A caller?
Yeah, he was a big-time caller. That's because that's the term. They're callers.
Yes.
Just Dance 2018 is coming out.
Yeah, there's a demo coming out for Just Dance 2018. That's the segue, gang, in case you're listening to this going, what are they
talking
about?
Hashtag spawn.
Yes.
Anyway,
so...
October 24th.
Do we have any photos of you doing the square dancing, Laura?
I don't think so.
In a pinafore or something?
No, I don't think there's any photos that exist, unfortunately.
You were right at the end of the digital era where there were people are taking pictures. Like, obviously, I have a daughter now, and Jeff has a daughter, and you're taking pictures. You're doing constantly. It on your phone,
yeah.
And like I got 50 pictures today alone of my daughter. So, it's.
I feel like being a square dance caller is like one of those things you would have loved to do. There's game show host. There's auctioneer.
Yeah.
And I think that anything where you use that voice and you're talking really fast, and then yes,
no,
Larry
is the guy. I never went to see. I've never experienced the square dancing thing, but the game show thing, that's my jam.
Mm-hmm.
So I've got the microphone. I'm really bummed because, you know, I went back, was down in LA last week and did the Cuphead and the Forts thing. I could have brought my microphone. I completely forgot.
What were you thinking?
I'm an idiot.
You need doors that you have to open. You could have revealed a car. That would be a great microphone for revealing a car.
It's a new car. All right, we're here talking about what we're playing. We got a lot going on this week. It's we're marching towards the release of Xbox One X next month, November.
And we're in the middle of like all these games.
It's October,
it's
which is a big month. I know, Laura, you're a big Halloween fan.
I am. I know you're not, but I am.
I appreciate your. I appreciate we balance each other.
What? You're going to be a Halloween fan.
No.
Because you got to dress up that little grub that you have at home.
Yeah.
Or perhaps
cute
like a
Halloween costumes.
Gears of War grub.
I will explain off the air how I've solved that problem.
Okay.
So.
All right. Fair enough. Now I'm interested.
Anyway, Halloween's here. It's on its way. Surprise. It's October.
I know.
Right,
when did it become
like
October?
After September.
Oh, that's right. Yeah.
Oh, they really shuffle that one around.
Oh, boy. Anyway, so we got Xbox One X going on in about a month.
Yes.
I was down in L.A. We launched Cuphead.
Which is awesome.
Which is, this game is, it's, these guys did such a great job. I was doing the live stream with the two brothers.
The Molden Hours.
Mm-hmm. And I don't know, did you watch the stream on Friday night? Because I was also joining us was special guest star Clint Eastwood's son, Scott Eastwood.
Really?
Yeah. So if did you see any? I sent you some of the photos, didn't I?
No, I didn't see
a single
photo.
I posted a couple on Twitter, but I mean,
what's he up to?
He's actually in some of the Fast and the Furious films. He is. Here you go, Laura. Take a look.
So we'll see him in 2020.
I mean, if you look at him, he looks like Clint Eastwood.
Get off my lawn.
And go to the, if you scroll to the, I think one way or the other, you'll see more.
Yeah.
So. So anyway, we had a great time.
He does.
Yeah, and it was great because he's in
I thought you meant,
I'm blanking out. What's the big robot movie? Pacific Rim.
Yes.
Okay. So he's in Pacific Rim and he was doing reshoots for that. It comes out next year. So he wanted to come down and play the game. And he's a hardcore gamer. He's telling me stories on the air and a little bit off the air about how his dad has a bunch of cabinets, you know, arcade cabinets that he's collected in all his different houses. So I was like, wait.
Have us over, Clint.
Yeah, right? Mm-hmm. Well, that's Scott, so.
Well, I know, but if his dad has them, I mean, Scott seems nice, but I'm going to go where the arcade cabinets
are. A fair point. So anyway, we played a lot of Cuphead. That was Friday night. We did it at Meltdown Comics, which is this, Jeff and I have done an event.
Yeah, we've been there. We did Ori, I
We did like Ori in the Blind Forest, which is right on Sunset.
Yeah.
Right on
Sunset. That's a great store.
Yeah, it's a great store.
That was, I didn't tell you, We were there. So I was, we're going back a couple of years, but I was talking with Hank Baskett, former Philadelphia Eagle. Mm-hmm. And he's a huge gamer and he does some stuff with like these games cases. He's up here. He is married to a former playmate. Not Holly. The other one.
I don't know.
From
not
the
Holly.
Girls
they
next
only
door.
Have two names. Holly and the other one. Crystal.
My
Bambi.
Wife's going to kill me. My wife's going to kill me. Well, anyway, at one point, we don't do a lot of things at Meltdown Comics.
Right.
And so I was just going into the back to get like another sticker for Ori or something. And I walk into the wrong door and I walk into them just like having a conversation in the back. And I just got a look. And it was like my one experience with the girls next door. It was like, why are you in our green room? And I just...
Oh, that little green room in the back there.
Yeah. So you're familiar with the green room. Now I got to look.
So Laura, that was a fantastic example of a story not really paying off.
Didn't really pay off.
It just was like, yeah, couldn't remember the name. Facts weren't quite...
Kendra. It was Kendra.
Okay.
Just edit it out.
No.
Just edit it in. Right on out.
Gonna leave it in.
Look, I got to meet Hank Baskett that day, and we talked about the Eagles... chances under Chip Kelly, and we saw how that worked.
Speaking
out.
Of the Eagles,
my family was
impressed. Jeff and I have a, we're going to get to what we're playing. We had a three.
See, I was teeing you.
That was the segue. That we had it. We played our annual Madden tournament, which is, in this case, was the best of three. New England versus Eagles.
Patriots versus Eagles.
Yeah, so we played.
All right, so the first game
at Gillette Stadium.
So we play every year. We'll play, we tend to play like one match.
Right.
And Larry usually wins. So first game.
Yep.
Tom Brady, awful game. Throws four interceptions.
What?
Just the Gillette crowd was booing.
Yeah, it was rough.
They won 28-0.
Exactly.
So then I was like, all right.
Then we took it to, not the vet, we took it to...
We took it to the Link.
The Link.
Lincoln Financial Field. And I won that one, I'm willing to say 17-7.
Yeah, it was completely
blocked. Yeah, so fewer points in that one.
And then we went to a neutral place. We decided to go to the newest stadium in the league, which is...
Mercedes-Benz Stadium in Atlanta.
In Atlanta.
Mm. The Benz, they don't call it. probably. And this one...
Oh, it was a nail biter. It was a nail biter.
It was a baseball score. I won on a game-winning field goal, 10-9. The Eagles
it was
over the Patriots.
It was close.
I really think we got worse game after game. I think on average it was about 7 turnovers.
Yeah,
per game,
each of us
with
were
4-minute quarters.
Games were decaying.
We had a lot of fun though.
Yeah, we did. We had a lot of fun. Madden is definitely a different look this year.
Yeah, I will give you that. And I will say one thing I really enjoyed was they clearly were putting in new commentary. So when I kicked that field goal, that massive 23-yard field goal that I kicked, they referenced Jake Elliott, who is on the Eagles, who kicked a 61-yard game-winning field goal like 2 weeks ago.
Yeah.
And they like referenced that in, and they were talking all about it, and it was really cool to...
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, it was not real-time, but it was very contemporary.
Oh, my goodness. How did you get that?
Well, Jeff and I were talking about it. You download rosters, so they must have just... It must have been part of the roster payload. Yeah.
But it happened real fast, and I was like, oh, I wonder if that means they're adding new commentary. And indeed, context-sensitive. So well done. Well done to the good folks.
To the Madden team, our friends up in your neck of the woods.
I was just there.
Yeah. I know you were. You were down in Orlando. You went down to Miami.
Yeah, I was definitely freaking out being away from my Xbox when all these games came out. And good thing.
Right.
I brought my laptop, my gaming laptop.
And you had...
And I had Cuphead.
You had
and
Cuphead.
And I had Forza 7.
Mm, yeah.
And I had a few other things.
A bunch of other... You had Ori.
Yeah. Ori and the Blind Forest Definitive Edition.
Anyway, so we played our Madden. I've been playing... So I really haven't had a lot of chance. Of course, I've been playing Cuphead. Have you had a chance to play Cuphead, Laura?
Not yet.
Laura, I don't recall this. Are you a animated cartoon fan?
I do like animation. Fantastic.
Like old school animation?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so like I'm a huge... I think we've talked about this.
You're a Tex Averyman.
Absolutely. My sisters and I grew up on Bugs Bunny, and to this day we still quote Bugs Bunny. It's still part of our normal lexicon. So the Cuphead, I'm sure you've seen the videos. A lot of people have been raving about it. It is pitch perfect, I believe is the best way to describe it.
Mm. Wow. That's high marks.
The game itself, the gameplay is unforgiving, mm-hmm. but the neat part about it is, again, it's an Xbox Planet War title. The levels are like 90 seconds, 2 minutes long.
It's one of those things. You're never going to, or unlikely you're going to beat something on its first attempt. So you could put it hours and hours and hours, and we all did, except for you. But then when you actually have like a good run and you actually beat a boss, a lot of times it's under 2 minutes.
Yeah.
And you're graded on your skill, your parries, how many hit points you had left, and your time.
Yeah. So anyway, check it out, Cuphead. You see all the videos. It's as good as people think it is. You got to play it.
Oh, yes. Fantastic art. Just absolutely mind-blowing.
I got to get some artwork done. I changed my Twitter profile picture. I got to change it back to my Eclipse one, the one with the Xbox.
Are you Cuphead or Mugman?
I'm both. I'm both.
Okay.
I'm Cuphead. That's fair. So that's, I got to expect right down the middle. Right down the middle. That's good. What else am I playing? Of course, Forza Motorsport 7 is out. That is just beautiful. I'm playing it on, I got a chance to play it on Xbox One X, and it looks just phenomenal, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah.
The rain is unbelievable. I think
I'm actually playing in Dash. I never play in Dash because it's a little harder to play in Dash, but it looks so
first person.
Good. Yeah. Yes. You know, there's a couple different, like, sort of, there's the hood view, and then there's, like, the chase cam, and then the wider chase cam. But the one where you actually see your, because you can customize your drivers now for the first time. And so I want to see the driving gloves that I, you know, in the outfit that I picked out.
What are you wearing, if I may?
I switched, like, every other race. So I think I was wearing something that looked very like Southwestern themed. I think it was
like cowboy boots?
Like a cactus almost thing. And then I was running one like a Forza Horizon 3 skin for a while. I'm constantly swapping them out. Like when you level up, there's a couple different sort of like level meters. One is like how good your car collection is. And then another one is on just like, you know, how much, you know, from your racing prowess. But like every time you get a choice of like, you get to choose either money, a car, or the outfit. I'm almost always going for the outfit.
Yeah, I got a chance to do this. We did it at the we did the stream from the Peterson Car Museum, which you've been to.
I've only driven by it.
It's fun. Laura, you haven't been.
Where is that?
It's in L.A.
Okay.
It is an unbelievable car museum. Got a chance to speak with those guys. I was there with Tanner Faust, who I've worked with.
Oh, I've worked with him
really?
Too.
I remember Tanner.
Yeah. He's the drift king. Of
yeah, he is.
He was on
California.
American Top Gear.
Yeah.
Probably the best driver that's probably been on American.
Yeah, he was busting my chops about because I don't. Were you here? I think you joined us, Jeff. Remember when I had the jumpsuit?
Yes.
You're okay.
Yeah. Oh.
I know you can't. Sorry.
Did he remember the jumpsuit?
Yes. He did. So Tanner was there, and also Joseph Newgarden, who won the Indy 500. Mm. He was a huge gamer. In fact, he started getting interested in racing from Forza, like back in the day.
That's amazing. That's
cool. So he was, and he was really good. So I got to race with those guys, and I promptly lost, which is expected.
If you had won, I'd worry.
Yeah, so it was great to be with those guys. So anyway, Forza Motorsport 7. Now, again, Xbox Play Anywhere title. Play it on your, if you got a PC that's powerful enough, it looks stunning. This is an Xbox One X enhanced title. So if you buy the title now and you purchase an Xbox One X, there's going to be more stuff to make it look better.
It's going to look amazing.
That's my official marketing 4K, term. 16. More stuff to make it look better.
Yes. Let's put that on the box. Like maybe with you winking a la Cuphead.
More stuff to make you look better. Dun, 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 dun. Anyway, so that's what I'm playing now. What are you playing, Laura?
So I am still stuck in Destiny. I've been going back to
stuck?
That.
Stuck?
Well, like, I haven't had a chance to play all the new things yet, because I'm still working my way through
Destiny. Why do you not play with us? Why don't you play with Jeff and I?
What's your light level?
I'm level 8 at the moment, so not
so you have to finish the story.
Anyway, I still have to finish the story. Not 20 yet.
How power level you? Okay, come on.
It seems like we play at different times, because I play, earlier on in the evening, and you guys seem to lock in a little bit later. But that's okay. Maybe we can coordinate.
If you tell me to, I can rearrange my schedule as best I can.
We can run you through the campaign and
assuming we're not throwing Hail Marys and
I don't know. I wouldn't mind going back.
I know.
What are you fumbling my football?
I'm just saying. If we're not playing, I would love to play with you, Laura. I would love to. What? And you're rolling as a Titan or a Warlock?
Warlock,
right?
A Woken Warlock. Yes, it's probably an obvious choice for me, but I'm actually really enjoying it. It's really great.
There's nothing obvious about you at all.
And then I'm also trying to finish my season 11 challenges in Diablo 3.
Right. You're chipping away at that.
Chipping away. Still trying to get through. I'm having trouble with the very last one for chapter 4.
Okay.
Which is to get through a level 20 rift on your own.
Oh, I was going to say, let's get to the community to help you out, but nope, can't do that.
Can't do it. So I'm playing a demon hunter, and they're usually a support character.
Right.
Like one that hangs out in the back and just takes out everybody.
So yeah, you have no one to hang out in the back of.
I know.
Your front lines.
I have to somehow work my way through getting better gear to be able to get through this rift on my own. So that's my last one before I get all of the awesome gifts.
Yes.
For completing the season 11 challenge.
Keep us updated.
I know.
Keep us updated.
Can't wait to finish
it. You have to hurry up and finish it because you have a new Middle Earth coming out.
I know.
Right, Jeffrey?
I got a chance to play that at PAX. I got to play at PAX and it's going to be so much fun.
Yeah.
Five days.
I think I'm supposed to go. I just remember my
They're right down the street.
I'm supposed to go over there and do
a
stream.
Why don't we go over and pick up our copies?
I'm supposed to go over there and do a stream.
Can I join you on that one?
Oh, now you want to join us.
Actually, I think I'm on
Now you want to join us. Anyway, yeah, so we got that coming out, and I know Jeff's excited about that, right?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. The previous one, Shadow of Mordor, was definitely my favorite game of 2014.
It was mine as well.
We had so much fun with that game.
Sure was.
Avenging each other and everything, and from what I've seen of the game, yeah, oh, yeah, there is a stream on Monday that we're part of, I think. At least I'm part of it. Are you going to be joining me?
Is it at Monolith?
No, it's from here on the Xbox Mixer channel.
Oh, awesome. Yeah. If I'm here, I'll do it.
All right. Well, we'll...
you want to come join us, Laura?
Send me an invite.
Oh, come on. Really?
Forward me the invite. Okay.
All right. All right. Well, and then, of course, you, dear listener, you're welcome to join us as well. Just go over to mixer.com/Xbox.
Xbox, Monday afternoon.
You can join us as well and see what happens there.
That's going to be fun.
Could be fun. Monday afternoon. I'm shooting a couple things, but anyway. So anyway, so that's what you're playing.
Yeah. That's pretty much it.
Yeah.
Looking forward to getting a hold of all the awesome games that are coming out, like Cuphead 27 and Shadow of Mordor.
Talked about Jeff's playing Destiny. Yeah. What else are you playing?
Oh, a ton of Destiny. Got my light level up like 20 points in the last day. It's my favorite.
What
it's
is
conference
light level?
Call season. It's only like 264.
Yeah, I'm
not too far behind now.
No. What are you at?
Well,
I'm rolling around like 110 or something like that.
I'm 240, okay. 250, I think is where I am.
Yeah, so I'm ready to run a Nightfall. We'll do that pretty soon. We should do that.
Awesome.
So I'm playing a stylistic shooter. Some people are saying it's a little bit too difficult. It's an indie game.
Who's saying that? Who?
Two-dimensional. really fast-paced, tough bosses. I'm, of course, talking about Ruiner. Record Scratch?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, Cuphead's not that hard. So so Ruiner is from Devolver Digital's an Xbox Play Anywhere game. While I was traveling, this came out. And it is like, it's a really cool game. It has like sort of like a Blade Runner aesthetic. And you have a helmet with messages on it. I'm assuming you're some futuristic Daft Punk cast off. Pretty interesting. One, a game that I totally had to put the difficulty down from normal was like too crazy. But it's sort of there's a little bit of Hotline Miami in this. There's a little bit of like Dead Nation, if you ever played that game, which is a cool sort of kind of like a twin stick shooter, but not really. Definitely worth checking out. Look at some of the videos, and that's available, again, both on Xbox One and on Windows 10.
Kind of segueing into some of the news stuff of what Jeff's got some of the headlines.
Well, of course I do. But yeah, there's been actually just really a lot of Xbox Play Anywhere games in the last couple of weeks. So there was Ruiner, there was Cuphead.
Yep.
There was Forza Motorsport 7.
Mm-hmm.
And there was two or three other indie games that were available all around the same time. And also, actually, Gwent. The Windows 10 version
of
Gwent
game preview.
Is in game preview. It's a free download, and it syncs up with your Xbox version. So go ahead and just...
I so worry about going back to that game, because once I... Once I enter the Witcher universe, I'm gone.
So you beat the Witcher, though, right?
Well, I finished all the main line.
Okay. Oh, so you
I haven't done the
game.
DLC yet.
Oh, see, yeah. I'm saving the DLCs the Xbox One Enhanced Edition.
It is. I'm only about halfway through one... I finished the first DLC. I'm a little bit through the second.
That may be the first thing I jump back into, because I cannot wait for that.
Yeah.
And I heard they're just so good. So, yes. Anyway, so that was one of the news bits, was that Gwent is available. Do we want to segue? Are we doing the full thing? Did you play the stinger? You know, whatever.
Jeffrey to the news desk.
All right. Now I feel better. So, you mentioned Halloween's coming up.
I did.
And, well, it wouldn't be Halloween without the Overwatch Halloween Terror 2017, and it is coming very soon, October 10th. We're only a few days away. Mm. So new skins. I feel like everyone jumps back into Overwatch every time there's a big, Summer Games. It was insane how many people were playing.
Yeah, so, I remember playing with you, and you're like, okay, I got my skin, done.
No, I ended up playing a ton over the summer.
No, you did. You did, but I remember.
But I must have spent $100 on loot boxes. I need to not do that again, probably. So I'm sure there's going to be new skins. I'm sure they're going to bring back Dr. Junkenstein's Revenge. What changes may come, I don't know. But I jumped back in recently to try out the new D.Va sort of loadout with the missiles and Mercy with her completely revamped. Look, she's actually
I love my Mercy, you know that.
New Mercy is really good. They're going to nerf her slightly, I think, because she's too good. But Battle Mercy's like, I'm all about it. Anyway, so Overwatch Halloween, new skins, can't wait to see what they look like.
Yes.
A lot of people talking about Battle Royale games. Of course, PUBG we've been talking about. Mm-hmm. The Battle Royale version of Fortnite, mm-hmm. Which has been very popular and is now available on Xbox One. The culling So that was the first battle royale on console that I can think of. That came out last spring. It's sort of melee focused.
Sounds about right, yep.
And that was part of game preview, and now they've gone 1.0, so achievements and all the like are ready to go. So if you want to scratch that battle royale itch, maybe could have picked a better analogy. This is a good time to do it.
Yes.
A couple other games out now, by the way. Dragon's Dogma: Dark Arisen. This is a game that there's just dozens and dozens of hours. It came out in the 360 era, and now is sort of a remastered.
That's a good era.
Version.
I like that era.
Yeah, it's a good era. And through the magic of backward compatibility, you can still live in it.
That's right. Yeah. That's right. Can always go back.
So Dragon's Dogma: Dark Arisen. That would be a game that potentially you might want to. Definitely, like I'd say, something of a cult hit, but like so much gameplay for this. Batman: The Enemy Within, Episode 2. This is the Telltale story. Mm-hmm. So Episode 2 is now available on Xbox One. An indie game that I've heard a lot of good things about, N++. You may have played N+ on 360. So N++ is now available on Xbox One.
People were excited about that. They're like, wait a minute, I thought I was going to have to wait. Yeah, I saw some noise on some Twitter. People were like very excited about that.
Yes.
N++.
And another indie game that, this is not my scene. But then again, golf is not my scene, and I love playing golf games. This game looks really good. I've seen people play it, and that is The Hunter: Call of the Wild.
Not a golf game.
Not a golf game. But I'm not a hunter. I don't. You know, I don't own. I don't go into Bass Pro Shops that often.
Actually, I disagree.
Really?
You're a different type of hunter. I've seen you when we go to Germany. You're hunting for those sneakers.
Oh, that's true. I'm a bit of a. It's kind of the same thing. You have to go and you have to find like rare NMDs and Yeezys and stuff. Oh no, you have to shoot deer in the neck. But hey. It looks really cool. So if you're a fan of hunting games, this one looks, the graphics are just phenomenal. And really, it's better to kill like fake animals than real ones, probably.
Yep.
I mean, maybe. I don't know. I hear there's a lot of deer out there. I'm not the person to ask. And then finally, well, look, if they took out the predators, you know, when there's not wolves to take out the, everything gets out of whack. Kill the fake animals, please. And finally, a new Xbox One S. The Assassin's Creed Origins bundle has been announced.
Mm-hmm.
Beautiful box. The key art for Assassin's Creed Origins is phenomenal. And that launches October 27th along with the game. So,
can we talk about it for a second?
Yeah, let's do it.
Here's a little tip. Ooh. I don't think anybody's told. I don't think this is public yet. I will be in New York on the evening of the 26th at the New York Microsoft store on beautiful Fifth Avenue.
On
the evening of the 26th. So if you're in the area, I'll have more details on that probably next week or the week after, but there's just block your calendars off. I'm coming to New York.
So a little bit about this bundle. It's not, you would think, oh, it's just going to be an Xbox One S with Assassin's in, of course.
Yeah.
But two different versions. There's a 1 terabyte or a 500 gig hard drive. Has Assassin's Creed Origin download code, of course, but also Tom Clancy's Rainbow Six Siege, which enjoying a very long life. A month of Xbox Game Pass subscription. And Xbox Live Gold, a 14-day trial experience. If somehow you're listening to the show and don't have gold, then, well, that's one way to do it.
Yep.
It's going to be available for $349 USD and, you know, other values as well, depending on your region and the size of the hard drive that you're looking for.
So there's a lot of selections and choices.
Yeah. Oh, actually, in this story, it does mention it has the details on the launch event in New York.
Oh, it does?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Okay, I didn't know.
Your name's not. Oh, no, your name's on it. Yeah. All right, I'll just link out to it. How about that?
What? Why was it disappointing? Did I disappoint you?
No, I thought that they had left you out of
no,
it.
You're the
real draw.
No, Assassin's Creed is the draw. I am merely just the vessel to deliver it. Or something like that. Yes.
Larry, he's a real vessel.
All right, what else you got there for news there, Jeffrey?
I think that's more than
really?
Enough, don't we all?
Is it?
No?
You know, we're only, what are we, 5 or 6 weeks away from Xbox One X launch? I'll be sharing.
Four weeks.
I'll be sharing details of where I'm going to be for launch for that. Laura, let's do that probably in the next couple weeks. You're going to be with me, right?
I hope so.
Laura, you can come with us. Well, we can't say where it is yet, so.
Oh,
it's not here.
Secret location.
It's not here. Okay. You will have to get onto an aeroplane to visit it.
Mm.
So that's
fancy.
That's all that is.
But fly the friendly skies.
Hints coming out.
All right, gang. Yes. So we're going to move along here. I want to talk about after we're going to name the game now.
Oh, okay.
So if you're okay. Time for name the game.
Sure.
After that, I'm going to tell you about I got a chance to see a preview of a movie that's out this weekend.
Blade Runner.
I saw Blade.
You saw Blade Runner?
Yes.
Awesome. Can't wait to hear about it.
We'll talk about that in a second. All right. You ready?
Yes, let's do Name the Game from last time. us name the game from last time, and the game was Maze.
Yes, I've been playing that.
Spelled like the corn maze.
Right, right.
Not the
M-I-Z-E. Not M-A-Z-E.
Correct.
Although there is some puzzles in here. I believe there is a corn maze in Maze.
Wow, that's great. But it is a good...
It's going to freak me out, though.
Exactly. It's a good seasonal pick.
Yeah, that's true.
Halloween coming up.
It's thematic.
A lot of corn mazes up here.
There are, aren't there?
We like the corn maze.
So, who was the winner?
Who was the winner? I'm asking you. Don't ask me.
Was Grant from Cleveland, Ohio.
Cleveland.
Congratulations, Grant. His gamer tag is Sarcastic Junk. So, way to go.
Yes.
Good job getting the answer correct.
What did Grant win?
Oh, my goodness.
A new gamer tag?
No, not that. He got a lot of awesome stuff here. I got a big list. He got a copy of N++, which we chatted about before. He also got a copy of Inverse Deluxe, which is an ID'd Xbox game. A copy of Zombie Party, also a good seasonal pick. ID Xbox game. That's not all. He got a copy of Cuphead. A copy of FIFA 18,
wow.
The Ronaldo edition.
That's Jeff's favorite.
Oh. Jeff's favorite.
He's a good-looking man.
And you also, Grant, you also get a copy of Forza Motorsport 7 Ultimate Edition.
All right.
Fantastic. Grant, you also get a copy of an Xbox Live prepaid one-month EA Access membership.
Wow, this is games. This is so many games.
And that's not all. You also get a copy of an Xbox Game Pass for 3 months.
Wow. So the 100 games in there plus all the rest of the games. This is
so many games.
Grant, my lord.
You get so
busy.
Many
you
games.
Are going to be busy in Cleveland, my friend.
That's right.
You are going to be busy in Cleveland.
So many awesome games are on the list.
I mean, when your Browns are 0-4, you know, why don't you turn your attention to games? Games are good.
What about the Indians?
The Indians are good.
The Indians are good.
I haven't paid attention to the playoffs. Are they doing all right? Let's hope so.
Thank you, Laura.
Well, should we do another name of the game?
Yes, to get out of this silly sports talk, yes.
Dancing or sports, you've had your choice.
Oh, goodness. So if you, listener, would like to win those fabulous prizes, so many games, it's really easy. All you have to do is listen to these sound effects that I'm about to play, and then guess what game that is. So let's roll the sound effects. So that was Name the Game for this time. Again, you too could win fabulous prizes.
Fabulous.
Super easy. All you have to do is send me an email, lollipop@xbox.com, nccmajor@xbox.com, and let us know what game that's from.
And what do they have to do when they email us? Because why don't you go through that a little?
Very easy. Subject line, name the game. In the body of the email, what game that those sounds are from. If you want to, you can include your name and include your gamer tag, but all you have to do, just send us an email. Really simple. And if you can hear our voice,
yes,
you can enter this contest.
That's it.
I also apologize if you can hear our voice. You've made some decisions that you may not be happy with.
Yeah. But hey, they could win prizes.
That's
for
true.
Listening.
And to quote Blake from Glengarry Glen Ross, it's just waiting for you. Go pick up these prizes. It was the Alec Baldwin character.
Oh, I only remember the part about coffee being for closers.
Well, it's in the same speech.
Yes.
It's towards the end. Anyway, so the prizes are waiting for you. Send us an email. All right, Laura.
How about coffee? We should send coffee next time.
If our listeners would enjoy coffee,
you got to stay up late and grind out that light level, maybe a little more coffee, and you'd be running a Nightfall with us tonight.
Maybe.
I can rationalize anything.
Whatever,
I have too much coffee.
Whatever you need. Yeah, trust me, he has.
Is
he's
his coffee right here?
Yes.
Yeah. Smell it.
Yes. Yeah. Yes. That's coffee right there. I mean, I thought I drank a lot. You're just
it's good for you.
You're just an animal.
That's what I don't know if it is good for
they
you.
They keep coming out. It's all right. Well, we'll find out eventually.
I suppose we will.
So a couple things. I teased this at the top of the show. I had a chance to see a screening. By the time this airs, it'll be out. I saw Blade Runner, the new Blade Runner 2047.
Awesome.
2049.
Right. Sorry about that. I don't know where 47 came from. So that's a lot of fun. Now, it's interesting. I've done a lot of press screenings. I've been doing movie press screenings for 25 years, awesome. Just a long time.
Back when they called them talkies.
That's... You can't see me, dear listeners, but I'm flipping Jeff off.
He is.
But I remember this is the first screening I've ever been to where the representative from the marketing or the studio came out and basically said, If you talk about the film, we'd like you not to include any plot details or basically tell. Basically, we can just say we saw the film. That's it.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it was very strange because there's a lot
of under embargo.
I will say the film is beautiful and it's it feels 80s sci-fi. That's okay. Awesome. I've said
that. You've sold me. Yeah. The less I know, the better.
I will say this though, Laura. I agree. When I, you know, one of the questions, because I've been doing this so long, I always ask, so how long is the film? This film's 2 hours and 40 minutes.
Ooh.
So you may want to make a pit stop before you head on in, and don't get the big soda.
You're going to want to hit the little developer's room on the way in there, because it's a long one. So make sure you plan appropriately.
Thanks for the
You're going to see that next week. What else? You know what else I'm watching is I've been watching the Ken Burns Vietnam series.
Oh, really?
Have you watched this on PBS? Mm-mm. Phenomenal. In the United States Public Broadcasting System. It is, I think I'm 6 or 7 episodes in, and I don't know about you, Laura, but or you, Jeff, but there's a lot I learned from this that kind of wasn't mentioned in my high school history classes, to be honest with you.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I was like, oh, really? What? So it's, yeah, a lot of high-level stuff was left over. So if you get a chance to watch Ken Burns Vietnam, I highly recommend it. Do you see it, Jeff?
No, I'm going to rent Blade Runner. It's only on the Windows 10, like, movies and TV store. It's $4. I'm just going to go ahead and rent it, and I'm going to watch it.
Yeah, it's a good precursor.
I need to catch up. You got me excited for it. No, but I did watch that documentary on Netflix.
Oh, the one we were talking about. Sorry, I tweeted that out. Yeah,
Long Shot.
Have you seen this one, Laura?
No.
This is a fascinating documentary. It's only about 40 minutes long, right, Jeff? 45 minutes long. And it's go ahead.
I feel like it involves Larry David from Curb Your Enthusiasm and someone wrongly accused of murder.
That's all you need
to know. And Dodger Stadium. You don't need to know anything else.
And go watch it because it's on Netflix.
Yeah.
It was
really good and maybe a little moving.
Yeah. Yeah. So it was that. I really don't want to say anything more than that.
Yeah. Okay.
But go watch 45 minutes.
Yeah, not too bad. It's really short.
There's your homework, folks. Go watch the Vietnam on PBS. Go watch Long Shot on. I did a lot of stuff when I was traveling, I guess.
Because you had lots of time to
Yeah, in the airplane, and of course the plane was delayed, and all the rest of that stuff.
The usual for Larry.
Well, it's funny because I work with Ryan, who's one of our video editors. When I arrived in Seattle on Sunday, because I knew he was like, "Hey, are you going somewhere?" He was headed down to San Francisco for the virtual reality event that we had earlier in the week,
right?
And he said, "Oh yeah, I'm at I think I'm at 8:10." I said, "Oh, that's my plane. You're going to take my plane down to San Francisco." So it's well documented. I have terrible travel karma.
You do
the worst.
You never want to see me getting on your airplane because that means there's going to be a problem. Sure enough, Ryan texted me like an hour later. They were stuck at the gate for like an hour and a half or so because there was a problem. So I was like, even when I'm not on the plane, that my karma stink stays there.
Yeah, that one time we flew together,
right?
I got sick. That was not about, at first I thought it was about me, because I normally assume.
Which time was this?
When we went to PAX East. But it was about making your flight miserable.
No, but then there was
the middle chair, and I was going to vomit on you for 5 hours.
That's right. Well, that was when we were playing Switch, and you were getting angry at me.
Yes. Oh my God.
That reminds me.
Yes.
I finally got a Switch, and I've been playing Zelda.
Oh.
I just started. It's so good.
Now you know why we were talking about it at PAX, right?
Yes, exactly. It's fantastic. Huge world, so much to do. And I think what you're saying about it, if you have an idea of what you could do, you can do it.
It's the game that says yes.
That's a good way of putting it.
Yeah, it's the game that always just says, yep, you want to do that? Yes, you can. You want to go up there? Yes, you can. You want to die like that? Yes, you can.
Yeah.
Can and will.
I think I actually have some, I don't know if I have them on here. I had some Zelda sounds. So
yes,
the
sounds are iconic.
Yeah, well, some of them are just, I mean, the sound design in that particular game is just phenomenal. Anyway, do I have any in here?
You can probably guess what I started doing immediately.
What? Fishing?
Collecting things and cooking them.
Oh, yeah.
Farming.
Oh, yes. So you need to learn how to cook things properly because there's a lot of...
there's recipes. I've been experimenting.
There's a lot of recipes that you could do really well with, so...
Yeah, I'd love to get that list because I've just been guessing and checking.
No, there's some good stuff there because have you gotten the bonus yet?
And
Link gets really excited.
Yes, and you get the 5
hearts
instead of just the 2 that you're expecting.
Anyway, so we don't want to talk too much about that because you're gonna have fun with that.
Yes,
you're never gonna finish your other games because that game sucked me in for like 2 months.
Mm-hmm.
That game
I still
is
never beat
huge.
It. I feel terrible about that.
Anyway, what I was talking about is we've been on more planes. What about the time we went to Alamogordo?
That was we were on time, but then we had to go to the remote terminal.
That was a bizarre one. That's where we actually had to walk out on the tarmac at LAX. Yes. Remember that?
And it was probably
it was like 90
maybe degrees. The bumpiest flight I've ever had, the one going into El Paso.
Right.
But then
when you went to
Alamogordo,
the ET thing,
yeah,
the dump where you're digging up.
And then we went to a fast food restaurant in El Paso, and they immediately recognized you.
It happens.
I didn't hook it up.
Oh my goodness, that's amazing.
Yes, I'm that guy.
The tea had never been sweeter.
You look. Anyway, didn't we get stopped? Remember, there's that weird,
oh, we did, yeah,
that weird border control, which is nowhere near the border.
Of nowhere,
in the middle of nowhere, there's a border control place that you have to pull over.
Yep.
And we got waved through.
We did.
Where are you boys going?
Going to
landfill, sir.
What you doing? Right. Digging up cartridges? Have a nice day.
Off you go.
Anyway, so I want to hear more about your Link experience.
Yes.
Did you send me your friend's code?
No.
I'll send you my friend's code.
Okay.
Because it's.
Is there any kind of multiplayer?
Not with that game, but at least I can creep on you and see how many hours you played. I can't. There's no rich presents, but I can see that you played the game.
I see.
And how many hours you played? That's it.
That's all you can see.
Yeah.
Okay.
So.
How many hours have you put into it?
Ooh. Well, north of 120.
Goodness gracious.
Yeah. Well, north of that.
He's a traveling man.
Yes. That is true. How long did it take to finish the story?
So here's the thing, and I don't know if I've mentioned this. I have not finished the story because I know. Not
finished. Also, you can basically after like the first hour, if you wanted to and were amazing, you could just run straight towards Ganon and kill him.
So there's a. Yeah,
wouldn't recommend it.
No.
I know that there's the castle in the center of the map, and I know that I have to go there to finish it. And I'm having so much fun in the world.
Yes.
So I'm like, I'm kind of putting off the inevitable. So anyway,
I
look forward to hearing what you say about that.
Cool.
So, what else can I tell you? Gee whiz, you know what I loaded on my phone? Laura, take a look at this. I was showing Jeffrey this at lunch. That you can now get down here. You can now get the Edge browser on your iOS device and your Android device.
And awesome. I think the best part about that, I believe there's like a functionality where if you're looking at something on your desktop or your laptop, then you can pick it right up there on your phone.
And vice versa.
That's a fantastic feature.
Right?
Pick up where you left off.
Exactly. Right? I think all I end up doing is I'm reading and I want to remember to go look at it later, I think I text it to one of you guys. Hey, did you see this? And you're like, why is it sending me that? That's not like I can get it later. you're my living bookmarks gang. Somewhat. Anyway, what else do we have to discuss, Jeffrey?
No, nothing.
So I have a little bit of news.
Oh, news.
This is a surprise.
This is
unrehearsed.
Yep, unrehearsed. Do you guys know or remember me talking about an application that we built for HoloLens called OnSite?
Yeah, the Mars.
Yep, that's the tool that we worked with JPL to allow their scientists to better explore Mars.
Right.
That was nominated for a Unity Award. Unity is the engine that we built that experience.
A lot of games are built using Unity.
A lot of games and mixed reality and VR games are built in Unity.
Mm-hmm.
That was up for an award.
Oh.
Mixed reality, best augmented reality or mixed reality experience.
Do you remember who else was in that category?
There was some other games, a mural drawer. I can't remember the others. I didn't really look through
them. They didn't send you to Mars, though. None of them sent you. Only yours sent you to Mars. Exactly.
So I was really excited to be even nominated.
Yeah.
And considered as part of one of the best mixed reality experiences that have been made on Unity.
That was one of my very first HoloLens experiences.
That's right. I think I walked through that.
That's what you did. Because remember, I was like crawling all over the place.
You were.
I was like an animal.
Yes.
You're like,
it seems like something you
I remember Laura standing at the desk going, what the fuck are you doing?
Yeah. And I think I told you afterwards, like, you were the most mobile person that I had taken through that demo.
Right. I was trying to break it.
Yeah.
And we actually forgot a news bit that you just jogged my memory. We had a big mixed reality moment in San Francisco this week where Samsung unveiled their mixed reality headset.
Jeff's just T-boning your conversation.
No, I thought we wrapped up. Congratulations. No,
Did she say she won?
No.
She was building up to that.
You won. You won.
On-site won.
Okay, yay.
We are now an award-winning application.
Good for you.
That's awesome.
Now, how do people, can they experience this now?
No, it's only... you have to be a scientist working
at JPL. But is it still down at NASA? Mm-hmm. They pulled it off Florida?
There was a version of it that was created, a storytelling experience that you could go to Kennedy Space Center in Florida called Destination Mars and be able to walk around Mars and see the same version of Mars that the scientists see. But that was much more of an entertainment and storytelling experience because Buzz Aldrin, the second man on the moon, narrated you through it and you saw a hologram of him because captured in true life.
I remember when they were shooting that.
You do?
With Buzz, yeah. I remember when they were shooting that.
Did you get to meet him?
I was in awe. I was very few people will stop me dead on my tracks. He was one of them.
Oh yes.
Anyway.
So much charisma.
Yeah.
Like just amazing. Oh yeah. So there was an experience that you could have gone to see, but I think that's closed now.
It
closed in January.
Sad face.
Yeah.
Sad face.
But good news is that JPL is still using the application.
Yep.
And now it's an award winning one.
Yay. Awesome. Well, congratulations.
Thank you. Really,
Laura. That's yes, Jeffrey. Now would you like to talk
some
about
other mixed reality stuff? That's cool.
Okay. No. Go through it a little bit.
Well, sorry about that.
Sorry.
You said mixed reality. I was like, oh my God, how did I forget that?
Yeah, we had the October 3rd event.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then you made the mistake of taking an inhalation of breath to continue your story. I was like, she's done. So Samsung. So a number of our partners like Acer and Dell and Asus have announced over the course of several months, a number of different headsets. And now Samsung has joined with the HMD Odyssey, which is cool. Look, has these built-in headphones, or earphones rather, which looks really cool. Altspace VR has joined Microsoft, which is cool in terms of like community building. Mm-hmm. And I found like having an avatar, you know, on Xbox is cool and we all know each other's avatars and we can see who's online and things like that. But when you're in VR, having that avatar really like brings home that you're talking to another person and really adds like a really awesome extra.
Unless you've seen my Xbox Live avatars.
Well, you when have, you've used the you've clown
or the or the carrot no. or the butter carrot. Covered clown.
Oh. I'm change well, it back yeah, to the gold clown that was butter covered. I will steer clear of your avatar. It's a little scary.
I just find the most disturbing things and try to put them out there.
Have you dressed as a clown? Because I know you're scared of clowns, just like many other people.
Could you be a little more specific in your line of questioning,
your
Honor?
Avatar dressed as a clown?
Yes. Once.
How did that make you feel?
It kept me up at night. I'll be honest with you. It kept me up at night. No, I do not like clowns. I haven't seen, what's the clown movie, It?
It. Oh, goodness gracious, no. I saw lots of pictures of people who were at the early screenings of It, and they'd walk into the theater.
Right.
First person in, completely dark, you know, previews haven't started rolling.
Right.
And there's a clown with a red balloon sitting in the back.
Yeah.
I would have just turned around and walked out.
Yep, that's it. I'm done.
No, thanks.
Jeff, I know you love clowns.
They don't bother me the way they bother you, but I'm just not.
Oh, they
a fan.
Will. They will. You'll grow into it.
This is something that happens, like a late life phobia,
exactly.
Like developing an allergy to sunlight or something. It happens.
Yes.
Yeah, and then so last thing is like, so what are you going to play? What are you going to do on these mixed reality headsets? Well, quite a few things. So a number of games over the and other apps, of course, but you know this is Xbox, so. Games like Space Pirate Trainer, which I'm a huge fan of, Super Hot, Arizona which Sunshine.
Super Hot won for the best VR game on Unity.
It's
Awards.
So good. It's a great game on ID at Xbox.
And VR, the one where you're moving around and you're shooting. Right.
And nothing moves unless you
right,
move.
Right, 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 right. That was cool.
And then, like, the big announcement was that Halo Recruit, like an introduction to the world of Halo in mixed reality. That got announced and people got to try it out and I get to try it out. Yeah, have you tried it out yet?
I have not. I actually was in a meeting about a month ago where they were talking about it. I was like, I need to try that.
Why don't we prioritize that? We should do that.
You want I should get us a demo?
I wouldn't say no.
Okay. Laura, do you know anybody who can give us a demo?
I think I do.
Oh, see? Mm. She was being quiet until asked.
I know. I might be able to find a way.
So anyway, these headsets, the Acer, Dell, HP, Lenovo, and Samsung, all available now for pre-order. And most, I think, believe shipping this holiday, including like this month. So there's a lot of MR and VR things. So I'll just link out to that in the notes. It's an exciting time to be alive, Larry.
It sure is. Lots of awesome things happening.
But you can't go to Mars.
Unless you're a scientist at JPL.
Unless you're a scientist at JPL. All right, then.
Maybe soon, though. I hear Elon Musk is really hot on it.
Is he?
Yes.
Is he?
Yes.
He's got his hands
full.
He's
a busy guy.
He's got his hands full right now.
Give me my first.
He needs to learn how to say no. Right? He needs to learn how to say, no, I think we're going to focus on this thing right now. But good for Elon. I think he listens. Wonder if he listens to the show. I know. I'm pretty sure he plays Xbox. Somebody told me he plays
really?
Xbox.
Really?
Yeah.
Does he follow you? Can you DM him?
I don't recall if he does. I'll go check.
Yeah.
If he does,
maybe you follow him.
If he does, well, I'm pretty sure he doesn't, because otherwise I'd be sending him feature requests from a Model X.
Ah,
because I've already got about two pages of feature requests. So There you go with that. All right, Laura, we're going to wrap things up here. We'll be back next, unless you have anything else. Do you have any other awards you want to talk about?
No, I'll cut you off. All right. I'll do it.
Yeah. Okay, so, don't tempt him.
That is a fantastic offer.
So this is the show that is the award-winning... We talk about awards.
Do we talk about an award?
You know, you can find us on
Streamies.
You know, you can find us on Spotify.
Yes.
This show is now on Spotify. So if you're a Spotify subscriber, just go over there, look up podcast, search on Major Nelson, bam, be right there. So it's pretty straightforward. So we'd love to
like and subscribe.
No, I don't do that thing. But I will say this is, you know, I have my playlist over on Spotify, Jeff. You know,
which
that.
Playlist?
My gaming playlist.
I didn't know you'd published a playlist.
Yeah, I did last month.
Oh.
You don't listen to me. You don't listen to me,
Laura. You didn't tweet it out.
I did.
Maybe not in the hours where I'm awake.
Yeah, exactly. Maybe you were too busy doing something else.
Were you the one telling me about the Cuphead soundtrack?
Mm-mm.
Apparently, the Cuphead soundtrack is charted on like the Billboard Jazz records.
God bless them.
It's a great soundtrack.
It's so in
good.
Vinyl. But anyway, I refreshed my playlist.
That should be on there. Put some Cuphead tracks.
I have a lot of good stuff on there. I think it is. Just that's gaming themed and... Go ahead, look for it, Laura.
I'm gonna look for it.
Go ahead and look for it while we wrap things up. All right, Jeff, any final words before we
fade I've to, said more than enough.
Fade to black.
Too much, one would say. Edit me out.
Laura?
Thanks for listening.
Gang, we'll see you guys next time. We don't know when or where that will be, but we'll see you there. Thanks for listening. Have a great time, and we'll see you on Xbox Live. Bye-bye, everybody.
Bye-bye.